Let's take a look at how we went from this solderless breadboard to this printed circuit board. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And I showed you how to do a circuit on a mini breadboard like this one here, the solderless breadboard. And we transferred all of that over to a printed circuit board, and I'm going to show you how we did that. I even did one of these old SMD lights that we did in a previous video where we have magnet wire on it, so you could take a look at that. I don't have it turned up all the way because it gets so bright. Let me show you how I did that right after this. If this is your first time here and you would like to see more videos on model railroading, lighting, and automation, and model railroading in general, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell, and that'll notify you whenever I have a new video coming out. And if you would like to see more videos, check out my playlist. I have over 40 playlists on my playlist page that you could go through on any subject that you would like to see. So go ahead and take a look at that. So let's get going with this right now. I'm taking my original design and putting it onto a printed circuit board. And I rearranged the resistors a little bit on there. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take them from here and then solder them on this board here. That's a good idea to have a second board, so I could just, as I go, I'll just take a piece off and then put it up on here and solder it on there like that. That makes it a little bit easier than trying to solder it with all these leads sticking out of the bottom right there. So I'll just do them one at a time. And I rearranged the resistors on there so I would miss the holes. I'm going to have to, I have some jumper wires that I'm going to move on the bottom, but I'm going to loop them around so the mounting holes are clear on there. I got the transistor, two resistors, and the connector in, and the jumper wire. And what I'm going to do, once I get the other connector in, the power connector over here, so once I get all that in there, I'll test it out, make sure it's good. Got everything hooked up now, and so we're going to test it. We're going to turn the potentiometer, and there we go. All right, this is what I got done so far, and as you can see, I have the jumpers in there. I got the negative jumpers, and I got the positive jumpers. All I have to do is put in the jumpers from the transistors to the potentiometers, and I think that's it. I don't think I have to put any more jumpers in for the resistors here. Let me see. The resistors are covered. The resistors go here and right there. So that's it. All I got to do is put the little jumpers in there, and I'll show you how to make these jumpers. And the best way to make a jumper is, first of all, I'm going to strip some wire off of there, about twice as much as what I need. And then I'm going to measure from there to right there. And see how I have it longer on one side, and all I need to do is push the insulation over and then bend these down. Bend that one down. Bend that one down. Make sure I got them straight. Straighten this one out a little bit. Let's see if it'll work here. Now, yeah, I got them the right length right there. So
Just have to figure out where I need this. Okay, so it's going to go right next to the positive. So the yellow will go right there. Let's turn this over and take a look at it. And that should be the center wiper on here. So, nope, I gotta move it over one, because this, let me see, this one's, it's gonna be like that. So, well, it's gonna be down one here. So is that in the right spot? Yep, nope. I gotta move it over one. Okay, so we have to double check it all the time. So move this over one. Get that in there. And what I'll need to do is make a black one just like it. Now this one, I have a short black piece right here. So I'll strip some insulation off of it. And I just need it. Okay, so I need it to go from here to there. So, and you see what I do here is I go one hole past, so that gives me some room to turn, and one hole past on the other side, so that's about right there. So just cut a little bit off of there and then slide this back over. Now let's see how that one fits. Push that down, and that goes right there. And perfect. All right. Now we got to solder it. Now on this last circuit over here, what I had to do was, and you could see I bent the black a little bit longer and curved it like this to go around the hole. There's a mounting hole right there. So what I did was I just made it just a little bit longer so it would go all the way around the hole. I just have to double check with this one, my other board that I did. And okay, so the center wiper on that potentiometer is the third one. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So 3 and 8. So let's check this over here. I'm looking for yellow on 3 and 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so I got these jumpers in the right place. Okay, we got the soldering iron fired up. And what I do, you always want a sponge, damp but not overly wet. I have alcohol here. I got my liquid flux here. And this is one of those bottles that you could put paint in. It has the hole on there, and if you shake it just a little bit, you'll get some flux up on the top, and then just dab it with your applicator there. And then you could flux your connections. And what I do is I take the excess lead and bend it just a little bit to hold it in place. I guess it didn't have enough on the black one to do that. So clean the tip with the tip cleaner, and then just dab a little bit of solder on the end of it. And I try to find a way to prop my hand over here. I got it propped with my little finger. I didn't even need to add solder to that one. And then come over here. That one's bent the other way, so I'm going to turn this thing around here. I should have bent it the other way. But right here. And there we go. But what I normally do is I have my this thing here that I wear, and I check. I have an eye loop someplace, but I don't know where it is, so I just check it like this to make sure that I didn't jump over onto anything else. Pay close attention to where you put your jumpers and your components, because you don't want to make a mistake like I did. I ran these jumpers in the wrong place. Well, I was just one pin over too far, so I had to unsolder them from, you can see right there, there's still a little bit of solder on that one right there, but I have to solder it right there. Now what I did was I have it flush with the hole because I have to put a resistor across there, and so I don't want to interfere with, you know, I want to put the resistor as close as I can to the board. So I have this flush with the board so it doesn't stick out too far and interfere. So I don't have to raise the resistor up too much. I can keep the resistor right at the up against the board. Okay, so it's right there. Let's see. Okay. Try to flatten that down a little. Alright. Now the other end is right here in the same spot. And as you see, I put an alligator clip right there to hold it in place while I was soldering. Okay, I have the transistor in place. I got the three leads right there, 1, 2, and 3. Getting ready to solder those on there. We got, okay, that's the center one. Okay, we'll turn this one down. Now you can see I have an SMD light. If you remember one of the videos that I did, I soldered the SMD, or I soldered the magnet wires onto the SMD light. Now that one gets pretty bright at 24 volts. Okay, because that one's a bright white, I think, yeah. Okay, now here's the other one. And Here's the third one. Now I may have a bad potentiometer on this last one here. I might have to change it out because I'm getting a little fluctuation in it. But there goes all three lights on there. Yeah, see that one there? That's a... I'm going to replace that potentiometer on there. But anyway, I would put it anywhere close to where you're going to light up and then just go straight on out to where, you know, the buildings or street lights or whatever you want to light up, and put maybe 3-4 foot of wire on it. I don't think that would affect the brightness of these lights. The wire that I use for my jumpers on here, these are also 22 gauge solid wire. And it would be a good idea to get that type of wire if you're going to be doing anything on your circuit board, because it works out really well. That's 22 gauge. You could even use 24 gauge on there. But there's our lights on there. Let me shut this off. This is 22 gauge stranded wire on here for the power leads. And here's what the bottom looks like. I would recommend getting... Let me move this out of the way. This is a solder sucker. You just push it in and it has a release button on it. And what you do is when you're desoldering, you just put this up close to where your soldering iron is. This is cooled down right now, but you just have this close to your work. And when your solder gets hot and melts, you just go like that, and it'll suck it right up. And that's what I did on here when I made the mistakes on there. Sucks it right up, and I think it was about $7 or $8 at Amazon. And everything that I have here, I got through Amazon, except the circuit board was through Sparkfun. And then this holder here, the circuit board holder, this will hold any size circuit board that you would want to work on. It's spring loaded, and you could lock the top up here so these don't turn, but I have them loose. But anyway, I think this was about $12 Amazon. Everything here is Amazon.
We'll be having an introduction to Arduino right after we do the video on my backdrop. It's going to be a short video coming out Wednesday, and then next Saturday will be Arduino stuff, and we'll be doing a few videos on Arduino. I'm not an expert on Arduino. I just like using it. And if you like doing these projects here with these circuit boards, then you're going to love Arduino, because it's a lot easier and you could do a lot more. The only thing that you have to do is learn a little bit of programming, and all the programming is already done for you. You just have to copy and paste and play around with some figures in there to get it to do what you want it to do. So check that out next week, and we'll see you.